So the story goes that it's their first day at the Packers facility, and Rodgers walks up to Favre and says, "What's up, Grandpa?" And that starts everything out in the worst way possible. And now, unbelievably, we might have the same scenario. I mean, the ages match up. Rodgers is 36 now, and now Jordan Love comes to town. Tim Kalishaw, Frank Isola, Israel Gutierrez going around the home. First, that the Packers made the pick. Second, that you're hearing that they never talked to Rodgers in advance of the pick. Tim Kalishaw, around the horn to you.
I think I hate everything about this. Starting with what you said, they had no communication with Rodgers, which you probably should do if you're going to use your first-round pick. When you're a team as good as Green Bay that got as far as they did last year, but you're really limited in areas and you need help on run defense and you really need another receiver not named Davante Adams to help this team, and all of those things are available, and you go, this worked 15 years ago and people laughed at us. Let's try that again and not help this team right now and see if we can pull it off. I just think it's great for everybody who's a Packers rival and bad for Green Bay.
Frank Isola?
Well, if the same thing happened with Brett Favre, so how can Aaron Rodgers be upset about it? Now, you want to say that the team should call him, give him a heads up. That's all well and good. I'm pretty sure he didn't call the team and give them a heads up that he wasn't going to play well in the NFC Championship game. This is part of the business. He's a terrific player. He's won a Super Bowl, but inevitably they have to change him out. And you know what? There's nothing wrong with a little competition. It's probably going to be his job for a couple more years, just like it was Brett Favre's job when Aaron Rodgers showed up. I don't see an issue with it at all.
Okay, but he doesn't have the luxury of having a better player drafted in that position, or a position player drafted for him, Israel Gutierrez. This team needs help, but they committed to a quarterback.
So by Frank's logic, they decided to make Aaron Rodgers better by getting him competition and practice instead of getting him a wide receiver, which can make him better. I mean, that doesn't really make any sense. When you're preparing for the future 3 or 4 years from now, it's only when everything presently is all set. And these Packers are not ready, as Tim mentioned. They need run defense. They need a wide receiver. They don't need a running back, but they've never drafted a running back in the first round. And it's just – it makes you wonder, like, are they suddenly putting a clock on Aaron Rodgers' career? Does he – is at 39 years old, does he have to be done now? And if I'm Aaron Rodgers, yes, I'm upset about this. Not because I think I'm going to lose my job to this guy, but because what are you doing? Like, you traded up for him. It's one thing if this guy was – fell 10 spots to you and you just sat there and said, well, I guess I got to take him. You traded up.
They have to look out for the Packers, though. And the Patriots did the same thing with Tom Brady with Jimmy Garoppolo, and they ended up winning another Super Bowl after, or two Super Bowls, actually. I don't see really what the issue is here. They have to plan for Aaron Rodgers, you know, 2-3 years down the road, not being a top-level quarterback.
But are you convinced that Jordan Love is going to be the answer? Are you convinced he's the guy definitively when his time comes up? I don't think so.
No.
Why not try to win the Super Bowl now instead of worrying about the future?
Mm-hmm. Kalishaw?
Yeah, the issue is they're not playing for 2020, or at least that move wasn't based on 2020. You're in the NFC Championship. You're close. But you know you're not as good as San Francisco, and you're probably not as good as Seattle. And there's a bunch of teams in the NFC that are coming up at you, maybe including the Vikings in your own division. Get something to help you in the first round, not plan for 2025.
So he's not Brett Favre personality-wise, but Aaron Rodgers is a different, difficult – I don't – maybe not difficult. Difficult. That's not the word I want to use. But it's his own unique personality. Yeah. Does anybody think this ends with Rodgers saying, I don't want to be here? You know, Kalishaw?
Look, Tom Brady is in Tampa Bay. So if that can happen, we know Aaron Rodgers can end up somewhere else 2 years from now, and we'll probably see that. Yes.
Isola?
Yeah, I don't think there's anything wrong with that. I mean, Joe Montana ended up with the Kansas City Chiefs. Joe Namath ended up with the Rams, unfortunately. It's bound to happen. This is never easy when you start to say goodbye to a legendary player. And by the way, they're not saying goodbye right now. And I vaguely remember the Kansas City Chiefs 2 years ago traded up to get a quarterback that nobody knew how good he was going to be.
All right, so Aaron Rodgers is Alex Smith. That's what Frank Isola is telling us right now. There we go.
I will say this. Watching all these players want to come play with Tom Brady, if Aaron Rodgers were to trade teams and it was a franchise that's more willing to just sign free agents, then you could – I mean, the what-ifs have to be running through Aaron Rodgers' minds like crazy right now.
All right, well, let me what-if one as we get away here. Aaron Rodgers to the Patriots. Boom! He did it!
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.